The fasting, you've done a lot of work on both doing a periodic fasting, water fasting, and also fasting-mimicking diet, which you can explain in a minute. But so I was kind of, I found it kind of interesting, like the reason why you developed the fasting-mimicking diet, at least I read in your recent book, The Longevity Diet, was, if I'm correct, because you were doing some studies on cancer patients. And is that correct?
Well, first of all, for a long time I had been thinking about how to get the benefits of calorie restriction without the problems of calorie restriction. So that was something that I was looking for. And also, back in the days in my graduate work, we were starving yeast and bacteria, and we had shown that this was very, very beneficial. So I was really, I wanted to look at the possibility that prolonged fasting would be beneficial. Then at a certain point, when we discovered that the proto-oncogenes, so the normal versions of the oncogenes that are so central in cancer, they are the genes that control cellular protection. So from there came the idea that, and maybe we discussed it already in the first interview, but there came the idea that if you starve a system, the normal cells will become protected and the cancer cells will remain sensitive. So then we started testing this in cancer patients, but realized that they didn't want to fast. And then I think that gave us an opportunity and the motivation to look for a fasting mimicking diet. So a diet that works as well as fasting, but allows patients to eat. And this was funded by the National Cancer Institute first, and then by the National Institute on Aging. And so it's, of course, exploring all these understanding, all the understanding of the connection between, let's say, amino acids and TOR and IGF-1, sugars or certain sugars, and PKA. Actually, we've shown that, as we had shown for yeast, we've now shown in mammalian cells that glucose levels activate PKA. So that's part of the, that's a lot of what went into the development of a diet that can nourish the patient and yet have effects on IGF-1, IGF-PP1, ketone bodies, and glucose that is equivalent to that of water-only fasting.